So here's the bracket for on my old work table, and it works really well. So I have a lot of adjustment up and down to accommodate my unleveled floor here. But really what you ideally want is you want this member here, this steel member, to be directly in line with your wood, so the plywood top is supported in as many points as possible. But let me pull out and I'll show you what I'm going to do on this new one. I'm going to make it slightly different because I don't have enough scrap steel, so I'm going to change up my design just a little bit. All right, my table here has three steel members in it, but I'm not exactly 5 feet wide because I clipped it off on the end. I'm 5 feet this way, but not that way. But on this new work table, I'm going to put four steel supports in it. And now I've got this piece of angle iron here. I'll just weld in and fill this in, these holes where it had been drilled. I didn't torch this. That's not my terrible torch work there. But I'm going to be able to cut this into four pieces to make four brackets. Now that's not enough because I'd need eight if I was going to do it the way I did my table. So what I'm going to do, and then I've got plenty of this. This is heavy walled quarter inch 2x2 square tubing. I've got a lot of this, and so of course the bracket's going to sit on here like this, have a slot cut in it, and be adjustable. And but since I don't have enough of this material, I'm going to change plans, and I'm going to just attach a piece of angle iron to the inside, cut my slot in it, and then attach my piece this way. So the slot will be cut here, bolted to the inside of the sawhorse leg, and then this will be bolted through here. That'll be plenty stout. I only have this here. This is a 2x2x1/4 inch because I don't want to cut this piece yet until I know what my sizes are, but I'm actually going to use this. I've got about a 8-foot section of this 3x3, so that's going to give me room to put probably two bolts in and have more room to get my flange right or get my slots cut right. And I'm going to use half inch carriage bolts, and so I'll just make my slot exactly this width, so the carriage bolt on the inside, when the bolt tightens, it won't turn. So I will only need to use one wrench. So I'll just use half inch carriage bolts, and so let me go ahead and start getting this cut down. Now this is going to be where I'm going to try to show you a couple different ways, but I'm going to do it the way I can do it most easily. Now I can cut all this stuff pretty easily with my Milwaukee Portaband, and so I can make real accurate cuts on this. And I know not many people are going to have that machine, but you could make these cuts using just a regular angle grinder and thin cutoff wheels. It's a pain, and it's going to cost you. Those things are about $3 each, and it'll probably take you about four or five cutoff wheels to make all your cuts and then cut all your slots in it. But it can be done, and that's the way I did it on this first one. And but now I have a cutting torch and a portaband, so I'm going to drill my holes in here to determine where my top and bottom bound is for the bolts, and then I'm just going to go ahead and reach inside here and cut that out with the cutting torch. Now the other thing that works really well is if you have a Sawzall. I have a Sawzall Porter Cable one, a Tiger Saw, and Lennox makes some incredible bits or blades for those, of bimetal metal cutting blades that will cut through this pretty easily. Make a slot in there, either with the angle grinder, or you could start it off by drilling some perforations with a small drill bit, and then just enough to be able to slip that Sawzall blade in there, and you'll be shocked at how fast that Sawzall will cut even quarter inch steel. Those are some serious blades, those Lennox. I think they're called the Gold Line. So this is one of my favorite methods for cutting off flats and angle iron really accurately. So I'm going to use my Portaband and you just clamp a sketchy old piece of 2x4 or whatever wood you've got underneath it, and then clamp it to your table. And so as you cut it off, so here's my cut line that I'm going to go for. I've got it scribed on the other side too. So I scribed that with that tungsten carbide marker. So as you cut it off, this is still supported here, so it's not going to fall and make a, you know, damage your cut edge or fall on your foot or some of your other material that may, you don't want a clunky piece of steel falling on. Cut this left-handed so you can see what's going on. Go on, get. Oh, I'm not very good left-handed. There's a nice clean cut. Minimal amount of cleanup on it. Kind of a dork left-handed though.